Hello everyone, welcome back to the Chemical Engineering channel. I am very thankful to all of those who have subscribed this channel, and I will request all of the valuable viewers who are watching and currently not subscribing are requested to please subscribe the channel and click on bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. So today's video, we will be discussing again the sulfuric acid industry, but for this time we will be discussing the lead chamber process. So before starting this video, please watch the previous video. I'm giving its link in the description and the pop-up as well. So in the previous video, we have discussed that sulfuric acid can be manufactured from two processes, lead chamber process and contact process. So in the previous video, we had discussed the contact process, and in this video, we will not only be discussing the lead chamber process, but the difference or the comparison between these two processes. So for a refresher, let's look at the uses of sulfuric acid. That it is used in the preparation of the chemicals like fertilizers, metal sulfates, nitric acid, phosphoric acid, TNT, nitrocellulose, explosives, purification of petroleum, production of dyes for the extraction of copper and uranium from ores, and serves as an electrolyte in the lead acid battery. So for this process, which is the lead chamber process, the raw materials required are three. Number one is the iron pyrite, which contains 54% silica. Sometimes arsenic is also present in it as impurity, so it is necessary to be removed so that it does not poison the catalyst. Number two is air, which is used as a source of oxygen. Number three is oxides of nitrogen, nitrogen oxide. So the main step of production is divided into four steps. Number one is the burning of pyrite. Number two is SO2 conversion to SO3. Number three is sulfuric acid formation. And number four is nitrogen oxides recovery, NO and NO2. And the reactions which are occurring in it include pyrite burning, which is 4 moles of pyrite reacts with 11 moles of oxygen to form 2 moles of iron oxide and 8 moles of sulfur dioxide. Second, SO2 to SO3 conversion, 2 moles of NO reacts with oxygen to form 2 NO2, and these NO2 reacts with SO2 to form SO3 and NO. And in the last, sulfuric acid production, SO3 reacts with water to form sulfuric acid. So we will see all these reactions one by one, how these are implemented. So in the first case, which is the pyrite burner, air and pyrite are fed. Obviously the pyrite burning takes place and SO2 is produced, which is sent to the reaction tower 1, which is named as the Glover tower, and oxides of nitrogen are also fed in the system. Obviously we have discussed there are three raw materials, air, pyrite and NO, NO2. Then the produced SO3 is sent to the lead chamber, where by means of hot water or the steam, sulfuric acid is produced, which is 65% purity. Then the gas from the lead chamber is sent to the second tower, which is the reaction tower 2, Gay-Lussac tower. The waste gases are released from this process, while the product from the reaction tower 1 is first cooled down by means of the cooling water, which is entering and leaving as a hot water, and then these are fed to the tower, which is the reaction tower number 2. And the produced sulfuric acid, 78% purity, is separated out and sent to the storage. Now you would be thinking that how 78% is produced, and if 78% is producing from here, then how 65% is producing from here? Obviously, that's a question in your mind, but again, we will discuss it. Now the produced nitrous vitriol from this tower is recycled or is also fed to this reaction tower 1. And the sulfuric acid which is produced from here is also recycled back, and it is how that is concentrated. Where firstly, product from this tower is cooled down, is fed to this tower. The nitrous vitriol is fed to this tower and along with this sulfuric acid which is produced in the lead chamber, and it is further concentrated, or its concentration is increased in this tower to get high purity sulfuric acid. But again, the maximum purity which can be obtained from this process is 78%, while as compared to that of the other processes, which is the contact process, the purity obtained was of 98 to 99%. So this is the overall summary. Pyrite burning. Pyrites are burned in furnaces where air is introduced for burning, giving SO2, as we have seen in the reaction number 1, that FeS2 plus O2 produces Fe2O3 and SO2. Then in the second phase, which is SO2 conversion, it takes place in the reaction tower 1, where it enters at the bottom, and from top, nitrous vitriol, NO and NO2 are sprayed. Some of the SO3 thus formed is absorbed by the acid forming tower or glove acid, while the remaining SO3 enters the lead chamber. In the third part, the lead chamber, which made of lead steels, and the number of chambers may vary from 3 to 12. The gases from tower 1 enters the chamber at 90 degrees centigrade, and which mainly consists of SO2 and SO3. Here, these gases react with water, form sulfuric acid, which is H2SO4, but the concentration which is obtained from this tower varies from 60 to 68%, and it is usually recommended as or known as the chamber acid. And last step, which is the nitrogen oxides recovery, the gases from this chamber are passed through the reaction tower 2, where these are treated with cool sulfuric acid from the reaction tower 1. And the nitrogen oxides and unreacted sulfur oxides react with acid forming nitrous butyl, which is again used in the reaction tower 1, while the remaining gases are exhausted in the system. So as you can see, these are the overall procedures and these are the overall reactions in the process. Now, once after completing this, the lead chamber process, we will now move to the comparison of these two processes. So there are a total of 8 comparisons. We will look at these one by one. Number one is that the lead chamber process required much space and the production of acid is less comparatively. Now, on the other hand, the production requirement or the mole purity of produced acid is low. This process occupies less space and production of acid is more. In this process, iron pyrite is used as a raw material which contains arsenic as an impurity and must be removed before using, while in this process elemental sulfur is used from the ores and it is mostly pure and does not contain any impurity of arsenic. Then in the third one, no intermediate product can be collected from the process. Obviously, as we have seen that there is no intermediate product collection, while in that case, as you can see, oleum was produced and which was collected as a byproduct or the side product or the intermediate product in the system. The product is not pure and contains impurities, as we have seen. 78% means that the other quantities are also present, while in that case, this process is almost 100% pure. Furthermore, it employs homogeneous catalysis, while the contact process applies the heterogeneous catalysis. It has large reaction chambers made of lead, while it has relatively small size equipment. Again, the same discussion that maximum 78% purity, while here 98 to 99% purity. In this process, raw material is oxidized in the form of solid, while in this process, raw material is oxidized in the form of molten form. So you can see there are a total of 8 differences, but the main difference is, if we can summarize it, that the lead chamber process is a relatively weaker process because it requires more space, it produces less acid. There is a problem with the raw material as well as it contains arsenic, while such problems do not exist in the contact process. And as a result, the contact process is now widely used for the production of sulfuric acid. And another important factor that the oleum is produced in the contact process, while there is no intermediate production which can be sale out in the market as well. So that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel, Chemical Engineering Channel. Stay tuned for the next lecture on chemical process industries. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned.